Yeah, so like this EU, this would have been a really good one to do that new thing that we're talking about with like the pair of the month, right? When we started looking at it, it was somewhere like this ballpark. Let me throw this on here, make it a little bit easier. Hey, we're all learning. I just learned about it today too, right? We're always going to be learning, man. That's a good thing. I learn something new every day. And I love it. Yeah, I like the dark brown background too. That's why I use the glasses in the morning, but it's just hard for me to see. So like this EU would have been a perfect example of what Daniel was suggesting. This is when we started looking at this pattern and we were ultimately looking for price to come up into the kill zone and then come down. So this would have been a really good one to follow. We're basically looking for price to, you know, come up into this kill zone here. There was I forget what time frame, there was a candle up in here. And this almost came all the way to the top too, which was pretty wild. And then it fell. And this was the big target here. So like just finding stuff like this, it's really important because that's what you want to do on higher time frames, right? It's not so much about, I got to get an entry from here. It's more like what's more important than figuring out an entry in here is figuring out where price is going to go. So like, what I'm talking about is figuring out, right, like your starting point here and where price is going to go. So for example, we have our starting point and then our finish would be, you know, under August low or maybe into the Fib TP levels, right? Once you have that, you're going to get multiple entries. Right. So ideally, this is what we were looking for. We were looking at a 1 hour buy in here, which we knew was short term. We knew where we had to phase out of our position, start profit taking, right? Kill zone area. All my markers and everything's different now. Oh, there we go. Right. So we would phase out up in this ballpark here. Right. And then we were looking for this. So that would have been a really good one to follow. Most traders, they just get involved in trades that, you know, they'll look at this and they'll say, oh, wow, it's bullish. It just broke this. It's breaking structure. It's going up. They'll look for buys. And then, you know, next thing you know, price just runs into an area and then it just slams aggressively in the opposite direction. And really no idea why. So it's really important to identify these, especially if you do not have consistency with your trading. This should be your primary focus, because if you don't have this, you figuring out entries and exits and trade management, it's not going to help you. You have to figure out your higher time frame directional buys. You have to figure out potential starting points and then continue, you know, where would you expect price to finish up? Where do you expect that new expansion to target, right? Let me clear that, because what happens there is so many people, like it's not really, you know, so important about, you know, like I said, working in entries here, like you're going to find entries because time is what you really have to look at. Right. So let me just flick on this. So you can see this move from this swing high to this swing low, right? This was partially this week, then, or this week here I'm talking about, then you have one full week, two full week, three and a half full weeks of price from this high to this low, all right? So you got to think, right? If price is going to come from this point to this point, and then that's going to start the continuation down into these Fib TP levels, how much time are you talking, right? You got to be looking at maybe 1 week, 2 week for the pullback, and then, you know, maybe 4 weeks of that continuation move. So like that's where it's so powerful to find your directional bias. And then, right, once, like I said, you don't have to worry about working in entries here. You don't have to worry about working in entries, you know, like getting your tight entries in here. It's really important to get this, know that. And then in this move here, knowing that that's going to be multiple weeks, if not longer, you're going to get all of the entries that you could possibly wish for. Does that make sense? Find liquidity, baby. Find where they are in That's the key. Like, if you can do something like this accurately, then you can work in your entries. Like, if you do something like this accurately and you can determine this, right? We anticipated this move when price was doing, when we had that 1 hour buy here. Some of you may remember that buy, because we talked about this one too, right? Right here. Remember this one? We were looking for buys, right? So counter trend trading, like, you know, it, most people, like I said, are going to get jammed up here because they don't recognize what it is they're actually trading, first off. Two, you know, your potential of how far price can go is very limited. And then three, price can turn on you anywhere, right? Like, we could have easily seen price just spike above this high here, capture liquidity because the 71 was right here, and turn from this point, right? Like, that move here could have started the big move, but, you know, it ended up climbing higher. That's the thing. When you're in a higher time frame of retracement, you never know where price is going to turn for that continuation, right? So you can literally wait for it to start happening and then start looking at your entries. So, like, I'll show you what I mean by that. We were looking for price to come for this low and come up into this kill zone first back here. Like, I remember looking at it and, like, seeing this set up and price was like this. And I remember this part exactly because I saw it flagging and I was looking at this and I was looking at where I could buy this after I saw this manipulation candle. And that was August 25th. And then we were looking at where we were going to phase out. This was our primary target. And then, like, the 71 kill zone, like, that's probably where I would have been, like, absolutely done. No more looking for buys. So you're talking about a move that we were anticipating August 25th. Okay, now let's look at one other thing. It didn't really start turning until September 3rd. And then from September 3rd, and that might not even be accurate. Yeah, September 3rd. And then from September 3rd down to this move here, right? Look at that. September 3rd to October 6th. Look how many weeks of trading with a predefined directional bias you have. One, well, you got some of this week where it started to turn. So officially one, two, three, four, and now five, going in fifth week and still pushing down. Yeah, so many options. So think of, like, what your trading would look like if you could accurately do stuff like this. And then, you know, the other thing too, like, when you have this stuff and you understand the big targets and you understand where price can potentially turn, you're talking about, you know, most of these weeks are going to provide opportunity that you can take advantage of for entries. And most people aren't closing it, like, you know, at the bottom here, right? They're in and out throughout the week. So, like, you could be getting in and out for the next 5 weeks, potentially longer. So, you know, really quickly, you go to a 4 hour, right? You got a nice play here. That was one that was talked about. Here was the one after this signature move here with that manipulation. That was the 5 minute. That was my entry for that I talked about live when I took my FTMO account trade. And then there was, like, another one in here at the beginning of this week on, like, a lower time frame, right? Like, each week you're looking for that manipulation or that pullback into a previous manipulation and then target maybe previous week low, right? Previous day low. And you're just targeting down, down, down. And until you reach your primary target or phase into, you know, the TP level. So the big question now is, what do we do now? Right? And I think this is really important because most, if you follow majors, who here has a watch list that's primarily majors? US majors. And this is one of the big reasons why I tell people, when you have a watch list of pairs that you're monitoring, you don't want to have all correlating pairs, because if, you know, you have all correlating pairs and they make a run, like, if you're talking about, like, US majors right now, and that's, like, the primary bulk of your watch list, they all just made runs, right? They're all like, look, here is the fib extension levels, right? Came into the kill zone, and now we're trading in these fib TP levels. These fib TP levels are of significance because we're gauging how far price can push from this initial expansion here, right? Expansion, pullback, and then we're gauging how far this can come into these levels here before price starts pulling back. And then you'd have, you know, a new range, a new trading range that you'd be looking at to gauge how far price can retrace on that before it can, you know, continue down. So, you know, you got to be very cautious here, right? So what do we do now? Like, tell me some information that is relevant now that, you know, this looks like this. And it's important, again, like I kind of got off topic there, but it's important like that you don't, like if you have all majors for your watch list and they all made a higher time frame expansion like that, right? They're all in the fib TP levels right now where price can start retracing. Most people shouldn't be getting involved with buying retracements first and foremost. I see way too many people do that and they're scratching their head wondering why I don't have consistent results. Well, there you go. There's a big reason for you. 100%, I can guarantee you that, right? So when you don't have all correlating pairs, right, you don't have to worry about this. If you have two majors on your watch list and they made their move, well, you just set your higher time frame directional bias, you set alerts, and when price gets into your points of interest, that's when you zero in the focus. Unless you have consistent results and you have data that supports that, hey, it's perfectly fine for you to trade retracements. Like, you know, this 1 hour buy here, right? I was looking at that, but I was well aware, one, I knew I was trading a retracement. Two, I knew where I absolutely had to be out of my position and start looking for reversals for the higher time frame alignment. Realigning myself with the big picture and start looking for shorts because I knew this was the ultimate target. And it also required aggressive management because I also know that my primary target this high here, price could have easily, that's the bypass pattern right here for anybody wondering, right? Looks like it's coming down and it's just making an ABC correction, basically making a harmonic here. Right? So I knew price could easily spike up above this high here and start going down. So I knew it required aggressive management versus my management for a continuation move. You need that surrounding awareness. If you don't have that surrounding awareness and you're getting involved with higher time frame retracements, selling and buying in them, right? Without that awareness, it's one of the biggest reasons why I see people. I can't tell you how many charts that I see posted on a daily basis when I know damn well that you have no business trading it. But people are going to do what they want to do. It is what it is, human nature. So when we see stuff like this, right, what do we do now? What's the issue now? Tell me facts that we know about this here. Yeah, we have a new higher time frame, lower low. So yes. Okay, but look for a break of structure. What would that mean? I'm just talking structurally speaking here. What does this tell us? You need to know this. Every major probably is looking very close to this. If your pair made a run, you need to know this stuff. What do we do now? Yeah, so we know it's bearish. We know a higher time frame, lower low is created. We can see that here. We can see that on a weekly. We can see that on a monthly. We can see that, you know, we have our swing point here on a weekly. You can see it here on a daily, right? We're bearish. We got a higher time frame, lower low, okay? So now what? What else? We don't have consolidation. No consolidation yet. This is still, what is price doing now? What is price doing now? This, what is price doing now? Yeah, it's still expanding. How do we know that? How do we know this? Yeah, it's impulsive, but what else? Yeah, creating in the expansion, right? Look at this. Okay, look. Weekly time frame, there's your swing, right? Let me fix this mouse. Okay, here is our swing. Here's our monthly swing, or weekly swing here, okay? Within point A to point B, this is going to have swings, right? It's gonna look like this on a daily 4-hour chart, right? So as long as we have that bearish structure within this bearish impulsive move, we're still expanding, right? Now, when we get a break of structure there, it can signal to us that it is starting to retrace, but it's not 100%. Meaning, you can see it here when I drop down to a daily, you can see swing points. It's still creating bearish structure. Okay. Now, if we got something like this, that still doesn't mean that you should be buying here, first off. Second, it also does not mean that this thing is ready to pull back. Just because a single high, like if you saw this here, what does that tell you here? If you were looking at this structure and you saw this swing high to this swing low, and then you saw a price push up here and it took out this high, what? How are you reading that? How are you interpreting that in the marketplace, regardless of the time frame? Okay, if it's a break of structure, what does that mean? Like, think about, like, what does that mean? If price breaks this high and you get a break of structure, what does that mean? Yeah, we can look left. We're not talking targets. We are solely talking structure. Solely talking about structure right now. Potential change in momentum, for sure. Like, people want to see a break of structure like this. Like, to me, it's still bearish. Regardless if one high is taken, it's still bearish. It does not mean people want to see this. Let's see if I can find my tools. People want to see this and then see that right there and say, okay, this broke. It's time to buy. And that's a big mistake for a lot of people, because that's still bearish. Still bearish. This is bullish, right? It's turned. You have more than enough structure to determine that has gone, right? So, like, let me backtrack a little. When we were looking at that other point, we were waiting way up here after it broke structure before we even looked for buying, right? Probably the middle of the range here. So, like, all we know right now, well, you guys finish. So seeing what we see here on Euro USD, like, tell me what now, if this is one of your pairs and this is what it looks like, what's the story now? You looking for buying? You looking for continuation selling? Or what are we looking for? What do we do now? Are you buying the retracement? And remember here, we're talking structure. Take everything out. Take imbalance out. Take looking left. Take liquidity out of the picture, because that's not relevant right now. What's going on here? Structurally speaking, keep it on a structure level here. Because if you can't get this stuff down, if you can't get this awareness down, everything else doesn't matter. Okay, it's still expanding down. Yes. Rick said, wait for a correction. So let me ask you guys this. Are you in an ideal area for selling? And if so, why? And if no, why? Yeah, so ideally, if you're looking for sales here, you're ideally looking at the worst possible place to sell. You're selling when price has already made its move. Price has already come into these Fib TP levels, almost all the way to the bottom. Like, it's maxed out right now. Up here in the kill zone, when it starts breaking down, these are your highest probable trades when you still have this low intact, right? As soon as you get past that low, right, you're coming into areas, unless you have like very defined targets to the left, like significant lows, maybe like this one here, like these two here, right, which are aligned with this low here, right, then you have other reasons for it to come down. But when you've taken major targets, you are coming into the Fib TP levels on a daily, weekly swing, it's the worst possible spot. So you're not looking for selling here. Like, it's the absolute worst thing that you could be doing. So what else, what could we be doing here? Okay, wait for pattern in a logical area. Where's the logical area? Time to sit and wait, 100%. Time to sit and wait, 100%. There's nothing here. Like, EU, done. And it's probably done for quite some time. Unless, you know, you're a consistently profitable trader and, you know, you have data that supports. Like, my best results come from trading these expansions here and getting my lower time frame entries or 1 hour entries or 30, 15 minute entries on this move here, aligning myself with the big picture. The only time I mess with pullbacks, like this 1 hour here that we saw here, that this was posted in the mentor charts as well. We talked about that one, right? Insanely clean, but a good grasp of the awareness, right? Of the surrounding areas, right? And if I'm getting involved in retracements, I have to know exactly where I'm phasing out, and I have to have something cleaner than clean, especially first week of the month, right? Or second week, if I'm coming in the second week and I got no gains, I'm just not involving myself with higher time frame pullbacks unless I have something cleaner than clean. And I also know if I'm going to get retracements here, I need to see more bullish structure than just price pushing up above this high here. That's not enough, because I know price can just be grabbing that high here and then continue its move, right? So in order to even be looking at buying here, we just need more. There's just not enough here. Let me catch up on this. And if we want to buy, we shall wait for price to break short term low. And yeah, I mean, there would just need to be a lot that happens before buying is really in the picture. You know, like, we're basically potentially going to be starting a higher time frame pullback like this. So what do we want to do from here? So we can just about clear that board. Right, there's your move right there. Fibs, kill zone. Yeah, so that's pretty much all we can do at this point, because, right, we don't even have that bottom defined yet. So even putting the fibs on this move here, it's not even 100%, because it could keep moving down. We just don't know yet, right? So we would look for our kill zone up here. Here's our kill zone. Now, given how this looks, again, you don't have to worry yourself about getting involved in price, you know, when pairs look like this. Like, ideally, right, like, this is what you could wait for. Price getting up here, maybe nice build of liquidity here. There you go. That right there would be higher time frame retracement, a buildup of liquidity, manipulation, and then a strong push down, breaking structure on this retracement, right? Giving you a manipulation candle and a signal that this higher time frame could potentially start its continuation move, just like we saw here. Like, that's ideally what you want to look for. Right. And then you'd have this candle here, and then you'd have multiple opportunities within all of these pullbacks, just like on this move here. That's ideally what you want to wait for. Right. So right now we're at the bottom. So it's not ideal for selling here, and it's not ideal for buying. So it's just one of those things that's just kind of shitty. If EU is one of your very few pairs like myself, right, there's just nothing there. You just have to be patient. And that's why we have a watch list, because if something isn't there, right? Like, if EU is one of the pairs you watch, the great thing is you probably or should have just racked up a bunch of money on the continuation move. if you got your higher time frame directional bias down. So that doesn't mean, so like if this is a pair that you watch and this happens, so what did you just wait? You just had, you have to wait for price to pull up here. You just got paid. You just got paid. Now you wait until it sets up again and getting, you're just getting ready to get paid again. That's all it is. Yeah, you can take a vacation if you want. That's fine, right? That's why we have watch lists, so you can go on other pairs. So let's go on other pairs. What do we got going on here? Yeah, there you go, Rick. That's exactly it. That's it's. He goes, that's why it's called a watch list. You watch it. That's exactly it. People need to get out of the state of mind that you need to be getting in trades every day, every single week. And I haven't taken anything this week. And I was prepared for that coming into this week, just because we knew how crappy it looked. We knew what just happened with all the EU, right? But I caught multiple opportunities on EU. So I got paid on EU. Now I can just focus on other pairs. It's as simple as that. So let's take a look here. What's going on here? Pullback and continuation, absolutely possible, right? Made a new lower low and pulling back right now, daily kill zone, okay? Flagging up, okay? So let's take a look. Anything of importance here that we need to mark up before we go down? Yep, manipulation candle right here. So we can see it right here. That was the manipulation candle. I was hoping somebody would see that, right? We can see all of these highs here. Cover it like that. And we can see price made a run on these highs, and then that was the start of the expansion. So we can also take our swing high to our swing low down here, right? Let's go to the daily, see what the daily has. Last up candle, I can see wick above previous week high. The area I have marked up, that's the area I marked up as a POI. For sure. Let's go to daily. What's daily looking like? Daily, we have some lower highs, lower lows. Here is our most recent daily structure. All right. So I want to look into this candle here just a little bit. I want to go down to 8 hour, and there she is. There's our manipulation candle there. That would probably be the ideal spot, because you got to think of it in a couple of different ways here. I know a lot of people are probably looking at this. That's a pretty standard move here. That's a pretty standard move here, right? You got this candle here, which was also taking out some highs in this area here, right? Pushed up. And then we got our continuation move. So a lot of people, you know, rightfully so, we're probably looking at this move here, maybe a retracement down into this. Now, you know, if that was going to happen, right? The 45 minutes clean entry, but depends on your plan, right? So if that was going to happen, this area here, yeah, I had a nice 4 hour up there anyway, but I'm not selling off of those candles. So I'm, again, like all we're doing right now is this, right? Finish point, starting point, right? That's all we're really doing here. Like that's what you got to figure out. Entries, right? Then your entries can come in once you get your starting and finishing point, right? You just need to be able to accurately predict this. When you accurately predict that, remember, like when you get this move here, when you get that structure, right? It's going to be weeks of price action. And you're going to be able to have ample opportunity once price turns and starts coming for major lows and comes, you know, it starts its continuation move, right? Like, look at this pullback here, 1, 2, 3 weeks, right? Then we got a spike up, and you had 1, 2, 3, and it could potentially still be going 3 weeks, right? You're going to get plenty of price action, plenty of time. So, you know, I look at these like, okay, we could get a move from here. If we do, this is where people kind of get tripped up on structure, right? You get your higher time frame points of interest like this. Why do you think I like getting points of interest like this up here versus looking at this price action here and looking for maybe like a pullback into this and that? Can anybody tell me why? Yeah, I mean, it could be a larger move, but because of the liquidity grab, yep. Like, are you talking about this? Like running on that high right here? Yeah, absolutely. Like that's what I was going to get into. But why else? Yeah, the candle, right? The manipulation candle, right? Like, and you're aligning yourself with the higher time frame kill zone and the higher time frame manipulation, right? This is just kind of like a middle of the road pullback before it gave its final aggressive push to the downside, right? Like, this is really the spot. And again, it's like, I don't need to know where price turns. Like that's the important thing you need to understand, right? I don't need to accurately figure out precisely where price turns or precisely what candle it plays, because rarely am I picking off entries like this. I mean, that candle right there on GBP, that's 72 pip candle. That's not what I'm looking for. I know, right? Two different scenarios that I'd be looking at here, right? First one, we'll take the bigger picture one. Because I'd be looking at this. Run on this high, or maybe. And then breaking down, right? Something like that. Right? Something like that. When you get these higher time frame retracements, when you get that higher time frame break of structure, like more, let me backtrack this, right? When you're in these moves, right? When you're looking at this continuation move, right? Once price started to turn, right? Let me go down to the 4 hour. When price started to turn and started, let me back this up here. Look, when price started to turn and break structure from that candle up there and from that kill zone, you're going to get plenty of opportunity, right? Now we know it's turning and broke structure in the kill zone, started breaking down. And then look, we have a nice new manipulation candle. We can see it's creating 4 hour swing points. That manipulation here, manipulation candles are great. Manipulation candles are great because they're starting swing points, right? They're going to typically be higher lows or lower highs. In this case, we can see this manipulation candle just established a lower high and a lower low. So we didn't need to pick off this entry. We didn't need to pick off an entry at the very top, hoping that that's going to be the absolute top. You can literally wait for it to turn and break structure. And then when you get that signal of the continuation move starting, right? Almost every single week, you're going to get manipulation in that continuation move, right? So here was the manipulation move, right? I think there was also a nice 1 hour in there, right? Boom. But either way, you have a nice signature pattern in alignment with the big picture. Price has already turned, broke structure in your kill zone, right? And then you have a new manipulation candle in alignment with the big target, in alignment with the big structure, right? Boom. There you go. There's your swing. Price makes its move like this, same thing, right? Let's wait till we see something else happen. Okay. It decided not to pull back and it decided to just give us a little bit of a correction and then slam, right? So we can take that new swing, right? Typically, you're not going to see too many big pullbacks when price is continuing. You're going to see big impulsive moves, right? And so you can see now we got another impulsive move. So this would have been the first spot. Boom. Look at somewhere in this kill zone. And ideally, it's the same thing. You're looking for one of two things, just like we would on that GU. You're either looking for this, that, or that's one, or this. And give you new manipulation. And then confirmation that that's continuing. That's how I got my entry on this. Let's run this. You'll get plenty of opportunity. And then we get the spike up for FOMC. And then boom, there you go. My entry was the 5 minute inside that candle. You guys saw that live. That was the first trade I took on the FOMC account or the FTMO account. Right? Now you have another area of manipulation in higher time frame alignment, 4 hour structure in a higher time frame continuation move, targeting this big double bottom and the Fib TP levels. There's the snipe and there's the continuation. Right? So you don't need to pick the top because every single week, almost every single week in those continuation moves, you're going to find new manipulation. Does that make sense to everybody? That's why the directional bias is so important. It's not about getting the top. Like when it actually starts to turn and you get that continuation move, almost every single week, you're going to get new entries, new manipulation within that continuation move. Like too many people want to try to find the absolute top or like pick off where it's going to turn. Just wait for price to turn. Like this is looking super corrective. So you're going to see one or two things here. Let's just backtrack to GU, right? We're either going to see this, right? And again, we don't need to pick this off. We can wait for that signature move, right? If it happens, we don't know, right? Or you might get something like that pattern right here in EU. That pattern, that 4 hour pattern, on EU, that would be the equivalent spot right here. After price already played a candle and started breaking down and broke structure, signaling continuation. Then it made, you know, it did this. And you had a new manipulation candle. That would be the equivalent spot. And then you had that. And then coming into a new week, right? Move down, you got a new spot. All right, boom, boom, boom. More manipulation, boom, right? Targeting major lows over here to the left. That's the easiest way to trade, honestly. And that's how you're going to catch impulsive moves, right? And then that's how you're going to get aligned with the big picture and you're going to have max potential with your opportunities. Making your short-term targets, previous week low, previous day low, aligned with the big picture, the big Fib TP levels, right? That's the best way to trade, the easiest way to trade. And the way that you're going to get consistent results, more people than often, try to get involved in every little move, every single buy, right? Oh, price is moving up. Got to look for buys because 1 hour will show bullish structure. Got to look for buys, right? Oh, manipulation candle here. Can't help myself. I got to get in that trade and start buying up only to get stopped out. Trading correction, price goes flying in the other direction. It's a lack of discipline and it's a lack of patience. Once you get those, then you're going to see. Like you don't need much to be a consistently profitable trader. Honestly, you really don't, especially when you get funded and you're talking 100K, 200K. You're talking very minimal percentage for a six-figure a year income. Like you're talking minimal. You're talking 5% on a 200K account a month to make six figures a year. You're talking 10%, right, on a 100K account on a monthly basis to make six figures net profit pre-tax, right? So if that doesn't force you into patience, then hello, right? I mean, 10% is nothing. I mean, that's an average of 2.5% a week. You're looking 5% on a 200K account on a monthly basis. You know, you're talking less than 1.5% on a weekly basis on average that you need to make a six-figure a year income. So the other option here, the other option here that could be a potential here, but it would be a little bit riskier, as Ray already pointed out, because, you know, these highs here, right? This is a previous week high as well, right? That's just a breeding ground. This is, if retail traders were going to come in and they were going to trade this, all they're going to do is this. This is straight up easy trading, because there's anybody can find a pullback here. They're reading structure too, you have to understand. They're looking for moves like this and they're looking for pullbacks. They might be using different entry techniques, not using specific candles. They might be using different FIB TP levels, but I can guarantee you this, they're using structure. They're identifying impulsive moves and they're identifying flags as well. If anybody in the world is looking at GU shorts and they're looking at this pullback, they're putting their stops in one place here. That's why the safest place to look for your higher time frame swing points is in the manipulation, higher than where everybody else is looking. If everybody's looking here, you need to look here. If everybody's over here looking, you need to be over here looking. It's that simple. Go on tradingview.com right now. Type in GBP USD. Tell me where the majority of people are getting into positions. If they're looking at sells on a higher time frame, 1 hour, 4 hour time frame, tell me where they're looking. Tell me where they're looking. Because I guarantee you it's off of that swing, this pullback, and they're probably all doing something along the lines of this. Maybe that break retest level is good enough for them to look for shorts. Stop losses are here. It's just recognizing spots like that, that you should not be putting stops, can keep you away from trades that are not in your best interest, not in your bank account's best interest. Let's just look. Let's just take a look. TradingView.com. And I encourage this type of stuff. Like, if you don't have that retail background, like if you don't know what the majority of people are doing, like sometimes I have to look too. I enjoy looking, just be like, okay, that's the majority of what people are looking at. Let's look here. Let's type it in. Let's just take a look. Let's just see how the majority of people are trading GU, because I can promise you this. I almost can guarantee there's a very small amount. Oops, clicked on the wrong thing. There's probably a very small amount looking at that manipulation candle that we just looked at. Internal daily swing point is a big break retest level. Absolutely. How do I search Great Britain USD ideas? How do I do this? I'm having a brain fart right now. Do I just type enter? No. Do I want to click on it? How do I pull up ideas? Why am I having a break? Yeah, I hate changes too. I know Great Britain, they always got to be changing stuff. Is it ideas to you? Is that it? Here we go. Here we go. We figured it out. I mean, look at this doofus right here. Let's buy this pullback. And yeah, it's crazy to me. All right, so here you go. Here you go. Here's the pullback that we're talking about right here. Here's the manipulation candle right here. And here's that swing point here. He just has his stop a little bit higher. But that's what the exact thing that we just talked about, this is what that is here. Same thing here, right? Break retest level, right? They're looking at resistance, price breaks through, right? Now it's, or no, support, breaks through, resistance. If he's getting in this, his stop loss is most likely going up here. That's a 15 minute. That's a 1 week. Daily, here we go. Here, same thing, right? They're looking at break retest, trend lines. Oops. All right, well, it doesn't matter. You guys get the idea, right? A lot of people are looking at that. So like, if this was going to be a point of interest, what do we do? Right? Because I mean, at the end of the day, price is going to do whatever it wants to do. And price could very well turn here. I just personally like to align, like, you will rarely, if you trade with me, and you can ask Luke, if you're side by side with me and you watch me trade for a month, you will almost rarely, and I'm talking about rarely, ever take a candle for an entry that is not a manipulation candle. Rarely. Like 9.9 times out of 10, when I have an entry, or if I'm looking at a higher time frame, directional bias, and I'm looking for a turning point, it's a manipulation candle. It's a manipulation candle. Because I know that is going to be the spot that tricked retail traders, right? It was a push into a significant level of intersecting orders, capturing liquidity. So like there's great significance there. And then that's going to be the spot, because these retracements, what you got to understand, these higher time frame retracements, they're building liquidity. They're accumulating orders on these retracements. So that's the very thing that I just, when I see this, right, regardless of like this break retest level, a lot of this would be viewed that we just saw as a break retest level, right? Stops above here, that's generating a pool of liquidity, right? And I personally would love to see price come up like this and then push down, because that would just be beautiful, because it'd be viewed as another break retest level right below a manipulation candle here. And we could see something like that, boom, right? But we know that this can be a big spot for liquidity here. And that's just a way for, remember, a lot of these big moves, what do I always say about significant moves in the marketplace? When you see these higher time frame impulsive moves, or if you see the internal impulsive moves like this, 9 times out of 10, there's a big catalyst for those moves, right? This big move started by this candle here, pushing up and taking out all of these highs here. That was the catalyst, right? So what would be the catalyst here? What's the objective here? For me, the catalyst might be this. That liquidity there could be what they need in order to start doing something like this, just hypothetically speaking, right? Like I would want to get myself, like to me, I don't see this as manipulation. I see this as a breeding ground for manipulation. Then once you see the manipulation, then it's go time, right? Because they could easily do it here on this big break retest level. We could see a push down, then we could see a push up, and we could get that double top, and then we could see a push up and then manipulation, right? Like, or we could see the manipulation price run on this high here, where people would, if anybody in the retail world is doing a break retest level, or viewing this as a retracement, they're putting stops here. And you want to avoid getting involved in opportunities that are aligned with those flawed retail concepts, right? So these higher time frame pullbacks, I basically like to see a buildup of liquidity, and I like to see manipulation. And then I know on these moves, right, we can see manipulation on them. Boom. And that's going to make a new swing point. Boom, boom, right? Like it's literally just waiting for manipulation and finding the key areas. Like it almost doesn't matter what scenario happens here. All we know of importance is that's a starting area and that's our finish area here, right? Whatever happens for the manipulation prior to this happening, great. Like I could care less what actually ends up happening. But once it actually does happen and I see manipulation and I see a break, then I can look for intraday, weekly manipulation, like we saw on that EU, right? And then that ended coming into the next week, boom, boom, like this. Then we have a new target here, previous week low, boom, boom. Then starts pulling up here, new week. Here's a new previous week low. Let's get some manipulation, boom, boom. What are we targeting? Previous week low. Like that's what trading is right there. That's poetry in motion right there. It can be very simple if you know how to just do this. If you can do this when you need to, you're going to be, you can have a very long trading career. But like trading's hard, like in a sense. Like it's easy, but it can also be hard. And it's hard when people don't know how to get out of their own way. That's when trading's hard. When you don't know how to get out of your own way, and if you don't have your discipline down and your mindset down and your patience down, then it can be hard. Otherwise, trading can be extremely simple. It can be boring as all hell, but it can be very simple and it can pay you very well. But you have to, like they say, when something is boring, like when trading's boring, it means you're doing it right. If you're looking for that action, if you're looking for that dopamine fix, if you're looking for that thrill or that need to scratch something because you feel like you need to get into a trade, then, you know, it's not boring and it's probably not being done right. Like ask Luke, and I know I say that a lot, but you guys can. And I say that because I'm not just like blowing smoke on here, right? Because there's a bunch of people watching. Like I dread coming into this office, and I know that sounds absolutely stupid. But like, just, I'm just talking right now because I know it's all waiting. Like I almost know that we come in and there's nothing. Like we knew there was nothing today. Like we literally came on Zoom to chat for 3-4 hours knowing that there's not going to be anything. Like, you know, that's like when I dread coming to this office, because I know there's just not going to be much happening because everything that we really watch is either setting up, looking awful, or, you know, in a higher time frame retracement. And we're literally just waiting and sitting on our hands. That's basically what it is. And we were like almost getting into something today. And I was like, listen, if we get into anything right now, we're forcing it. We literally just need to just stop and wait. Like, that's it. It's NFP week. All these big trades, just all these big pairs just made their moves, big moves last week. And we just need to wait for them to reset up. That's it. This session is hitting home with me. Like, and here's the thing, right? And here's going to be the other benefit. I didn't even realize, holy smokes, it's already 10 past the hour. That's crazy. That happens all the time. And I just completely get sidetracked on the time. Here's going to be the other big benefit of doing what Daniel suggested. When we do that group thing, and I encourage everybody to get involved. If you think you're not down, got it down yet, or if you're not there yet, like it doesn't matter, right? You need to learn and you need to speak up. There's too many people in this community that are struggling and they're not raising their hand, or they're not doing a good enough job raising your hand high enough to get our attention. But the big thing here is like you need to participate. And if we can do this correctly, you're going to see how valuable it is to literally wait for high quality setups and what those high quality setups can produce. Now, let's just say we all hunt one down, and then, you know, myself and other traders, we check out something, and, you know, let's just say GU is ready to go and it shows that it's ready to start continuing. And then we find, you know, a higher time frame break and we got manipulation and we're all good. And maybe this doesn't happen for the next 2.5 weeks. Maybe it's at the end of week two or start of week three, and we haven't taken a trade since. You're going to see how profitable it can be when we find something like that. And, you know, especially if you get involved in twin trading, man, you can get your intraday and be out by, you know, Friday, but you can have maybe a separate account, or, you know, just split your risk on the same account and hold one for the long term. Like think of like that EU I showed. You have your 4-hour entry. You can have your short-term target, maybe close it up at the end of the week, you know, maybe target a previous week low or whatever it might be, or set an equal lows or a low on the pullback. And then you can leave that other 1% running until the bottom. Like you can just capitalize big time like that. But you're going to see how profitable some, like just for a hypothetical, right? That EU trade, if you waited for EU to pull back, and then you got that entry there on that EU, that 4-hour manipulation candle. Hold on. Let me just take a look here. Who here did over 10% last month? Who did over 10% last month? Okay, so that 4-hour candle, and I'll do it from I'll do it from a week perspective. So that 4 hour candle, and I know we were initially looking at the 1 hour on that, but that 4 hour candle just to the end of the week would have yielded you 15% on one trade, and to the bottom, it would have been a 20% trade. And to where it is now, it's running 18 to one. You're talking 36% on a single trade in alignment with the higher time frame. That's what I talk about, where these have the potential. And that's from the 4 hour time frame. The 1 hour to where price is now, you're talking about more than doubling your account. More than doubling your account to the low down here. To the August low, you would have done 33 to 1, 66%. With one trade, one entry with higher time frame alignment on 180 pips. If you closed out that 4 hour, 1 hour entry in the same week, but still in a higher time frame alignment, on Friday, you would have closed 44%. 44% with one trade. If you took it at the swing low at the start of the pullback and you closed on the initial move down, you would have closed with 28%, 14 to 1, 75 pips. So short-term target, just under 14 to 1. End of week, about 22, 23 to 1. To August low, 33 and change, 33 and a half to one, 181 pips. To the absolute low, to the fib kills, TP zone, to the bottom it made, almost 60 to one, almost 60 to one. Is that not worth waiting for? Any one of those, even the 4 hour, to the end of the week or to that swing low. I mean, you're looking to the first swing low end of the week. I mean, you're still double digits, 12%. And not to mention, it provided two other entries. The 5 minute that I caught, and then the 15 minute that we caught that we talked about in the Discord that did like 10% just to the bottom. And then it kept on running. Right. So like once you have that, like you can do what I do, because like we don't hold trades over the weekend just because of issues with how much money we have involved in the account. But like you're looking at new re-entries, you would have had on this continuation move, you would have had 1, 2, 3, 4 entries, and they all would have done double digits. They all would have done big double digits. So that's what we're going to be looking for, those type of trade opportunities with the group, with Daniel's idea. And you're going to see how profitable it can be just waiting for something like that and getting that higher time frame alignment. Right, Emma?
What?
Right? Mm-hmm. See, she's telling you. She knows. That's how we pay the bills.
Can I text right here?
There's a lot of people on here right now, so maybe not right now.
I want to.
Okay, go ahead.
Hold on.
She's typing you guys a message. Press send. So I think what we're gonna do with that, I think it's gonna be very beneficial. I'll go see you in a second, okay? And you're just gonna see how profitable that higher time frame alignment is, and especially when you can wait for those moves. And then you'll see why consistently profitable traders wait for that stuff. And why also too, and probably more importantly, why they'll have no problem waiting for it to happen. Like, okay, I might not make money this week. I might not make money next week, but I know when I get into it, I'm going to be making big double digits. Knowing that if you're trying to make 100K a month, knowing that, you know, you don't even need a fraction of what we talked about. You can literally just get your 5 to 1 call today, get 10%, and then have the discipline to just shut it down for the rest of the month and then get your payday, get your $8,000, $8,500, $9,000, whatever it is off that 100K with 80% on FCMO, and then just rinse and repeat. You do that every single month, you're talking a six-figure payout, $100,000 a year pre-tax payout. I can see a ton of funded traders incoming with this new plan. It's really nice when the timeframes are in alignment. It is. And right now, I can absolutely tell you without a doubt in my mind that almost everything that I've seen and almost every trader I know who does this for a living as a primary source of income, it says these markets look like shit right now. Everything looks like everything's ugly. Everything made its move. And I can promise you all of us right now are just sitting and waiting. Like we're literally the sharks waiting. We're circling. We're not getting involved with this, you know, with the garbage trading. It's just knowing what you need to see. And when you have it, you execute. So why is that doing this? So I'm excited to do that. I'm excited to do that with the group and we can all talk about, but I'm not going to be the one finding the setups. If you post this stuff, right, in the chat and tag the people, right? Tag myself, tag, you know, funny traders, tag whoever, right? And say, hey, this could be a potential for, you know, potential for the setup of the month. Then we'll come in and, you know, myself and other people or, you know, other funded traders, we can all, you know, talk about it openly in the Discord group chat and say, you know, if it has the potential or if not and why. And then when we all come kind of come to the conclusion in agreement on one, then we can transfer it over and like post charts about it in the mentor chart section or and kind of just do like a daily update on it. Like, you know, when we're approaching kill zone, you know, where and how we look for entries, the continuation moves, like et cetera, you know, where we, how we manage it, this, everything, right? So, but I'm not going to be posting charts and say, here it is. You have to find them and then we'll come in and say if this is it or not. And if, you know, go from there, myself and other people and anybody who wants to chime in. And I encourage people to chime in because that's how you're going to learn. Maybe a pick few of the charts and go other, maybe a pick a few of the charts and go over in the lives. Yeah, we could do that too. I'm excited for it. I think it's gonna be good. If November and December aren't the best months, do you think if anyone is thinking about a challenge, they should wait? Yeah, 100%. I would. I mean, it's definitely not the best time to be going out for challenges end of year for sure. I would not be looking. If I don't get the challenge done by October, I'm probably not gonna do anything else till January. Yeah, it started. We're doing this ASAP. Like, it can be any pair. Like if you see something that you have, it has the potential of a setup that, you know, is following the bulletproof confirmation checklist to the letter, it has higher time frame alignment. That's the key here. If it does not have higher time frame alignment, it's going to be deaded right there at the door. Right? It can be any pair. Be like, hey, you know, something from your watch list. Right. If it's a pair that like odd New Zealand and it's everything's there, then okay, that would be the one, right? We're not gonna limit it to pairs. It can be any pair. Just post them in the group chat and tag the people, tag leadership, tag funded traders, tag myself, or just generally say, I'm sure like it'll be discussed. Just say, hey, I think this has the potential. What do you think? And if it does, you know, we can make that vote. But yeah, I mean, you want to put things in your benefit, right? You want to stack the deck in your favor, right? Like out of every year that I've been trading, and I don't even know how long it's been. It's got to be coming up on 5 now. I think I've seen like one good November, December. Like November, December are typically just not the best price action. It's, I don't know. It's just always like that. So I honestly, you know, wouldn't go out for funding. I mean, you can if you want, but I probably wouldn't. Like Luke was talking about, he's like, we should just get 200K accounts. And I was like, I'm just not going to do it. I don't think it's the right play. We're coming into October, November, right? I mean, you know, those are like vacation months. Like we got Halloween, we got people going to be traveling and doing the Thanksgiving thing. And then we got like between like Christmas and then like Christmas is like December is the worst, right? Like the first week before Christmas, like dead, then Christmas week, dead, week after coming into New Year's, dead, right? Like markets are closed and nothing's moving and, you know, banks are closed. Like it's just December is like, you know, I don't even open up MT4 for December practically. So October is the month you want to make your money. Like this time of year, like it's, you're wrapping up your trading. How many pairs do you watch? Primarily gold and US 30, but I also watch EU and GU, which I consider the same pair. But it's usually primary gold, but gold's just one of those. It right now, it's absolutely awful. Gold has changed a lot in the last 6 months. A lot. Do you agree with the signature pattern on New Zealand USD? I do not know. You'd have to post it. I don't have anything else open right now. If it's capturing liquidity, then I'll have plenty of time. Yeah, it's literally like the end of year. End of year is like November, December. That's preparation. Like it's a review of, you know, the goals that you set out for 2021, right? Like there's no point in like putting together goals for New Year's resolution if it's the same old thing and nothing gets done, right? Like you really want to set yourself up for success and it's all about planning. Like that's all we're doing right now for EFX, for EFXU, for trading, for everything. It's all about preparation so we can have a certain momentum coming into that new year for 2022. So it's all game planning right now. It's all preparation, review, and get ready because it's fourth quarter here. So, you know, we're about to start the new year, the new season. So it's all preparation right now. We're about to wrap it up. 2021 is just about done. So it's all preparation for the new year for sure. Study, review, back test, prep, taxes, all that fun stuff. So we're 90 minutes in. I don't see any other questions. But I guess that's all good because we'll be back at it tomorrow morning. And we can see if we get anything intraday for NFP. And maybe I can get something and I'll trade it live on the FCMO. That'd be cool. If we can get something, I'll just bring up the MT4 and we can just trade it live. I'm like right around break even right now. And I, if you're ever going out for those FTMOs, I highly recommend you do the challenge and don't do what I did. I've had to make so many adjustments to my trading that it just like so many things I just was not aware of. I've had to change quite a bit. Yeah, do the free trial. Absolutely. I just made an impulsive purchase for sure. I didn't know all the rules and I still don't even know the days I'm not supposed to trade for news. I would not do as I say on this and don't do as I do. Do the free challenge first. Just so you get the experience. Especially if you're somebody who does like metals and indices and lower time frame stuff, it's a lot harder to do. Like I had a lot size today that was supposed to be 80, and I couldn't even do anything past 20. It was like a 2.3 pip stop, and I couldn't even do anything about it. Even 1%, it was like a 40 lock. I would have had to like half. I would have had like four positions running, and. But even the free challenge is not the same. Like you can hold. Yeah. Well, I mean, just if you don't typically hold over the weekend, then it probably shouldn't. It won't be an issue. I rarely do. So I'm just talking in terms of other stuff. Yeah. Well, you can. You just can't execute. There's like a 4-minute buffer, like 2 minutes before, 2 minutes after. The challenge doesn't matter though. Like you can have a trade open as long as it's not near your stop loss. Like, cause you can get like, you can get waked out on your stop loss with like a F, like an NFP event. Like if there's something for NFP tomorrow, I'll take it for sure. I'm not really stressing the account too much, but like, let's say you're not allowed to trade it for your actual account. And let's say I had a trade open like 10 minutes prior. And it was moving away. And if the news sends price up and stops me out, that's considered closing your trade. It's the other side of the execution. And you'd lose your account. So you can't like end a trade with TP or stop loss or manually closing it within that time frame. Yeah, with the swing account, you don't have to think about the news or holding trades over the weekend. Yeah. That link won't open. Oh, you're talking about the desktop? Leverage is less on the swing though. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I would just do the regular. Unless like you don't want to change for FTMO. Unless you're already trading like a certain way, like I hold swing trades and I hold trades over the weekend or long term, like, you know, and I'm, you're actively holding positions for weeks on end right now. Like don't start trading that way for a challenge. Don't worry about over the weekend. Like, I can't even remember the last time I had a trade open on the weekend. It's got to be years now. I mean, and I can't really technically with the accounts that I have. It's just too risky. Like, if we get hit with swap or if we get hit with slippage or crazy stuff over the weekend, it's like we've had some stuff happen where it cost seven figures or multiple six, and it was just so ugly. Thankfully, it wasn't me, though. It was Brooks. It was like a $1 million mistake. Literally. I think it was just over $1 million mistake. His dad was pissed. Pissed. Okay. All right, well, I don't see any other questions. I'm sure that's pretty mildly. Yeah, well, I mean, they don't really have, let's just say they don't have to worry about money. So I don't think he was losing too much sleep. He might have been originally pissed, but they're not rich. They're wealthy. Their kids who are not even born yet, maybe born in like a couple of decades, they're rich. They're wealthy. They're set. So that's the goal, right? All right, well, we're going to end it there. We're just kind of chatting along right now. I want to be respectful of everybody's time. We're already long past. Every time I come into these sessions, I'm like, I'm going to keep it an hour. It's going to be 60 minutes, and they always go 90 or longer. But well, I hope you guys were able to get value from this, and I think it's going to be very beneficial when we start this. I mean, it's starting now, so if you see stuff, drop it, and we can get that rolling right away. It's the perfect time to do it. We're starting the new month. Let's end this year with some bangers. We got, you know, we basically have like a month and a half of trading, maybe October and probably like the first half of November. That's when things start to get ugly. So probably a month and a half of trading, we can probably find at least 2-3 premium setups. Yeah, drop them in the group chat, the general chat. That's fine. This is all new. So we might, you know, we might start like a, we might add stuff to Discord. We don't know yet. We'll figure it out. We're just going to wing it as we go, and whatever works, works. If we have to make changes or add additions, we'll do it. Other than that, if I miss any questions, just drop it in the Discord, and then we'll be back at tomorrow morning. I'll post the Zoom link right around 7:30 a.m. Eastern-ish, and we will see what we have going on for the NFP event. And if we have something going on with the NFP event, I will just execute it and do everything in front of you guys. I'll just do it on the I'll do it on the FTMO account. I'll be trading the other accounts too. I haven't even taken a trade on that. I haven't taken a trade on the big account. I can probably tell you it's got to be weeks right now. You guys want to see patience? I'll show you. It's got to be weeks. It's got to be weeks. It's got to be at least two, maybe even longer. I will tell you guys my last trade executed on the big account. But if we find something, I'll execute it live, all that good stuff, and we can do the trade management, all that good stuff on the challenge account. Make it fun. Okay. How do I raise this up? Let's see. I can't raise this up. The last trade I took was on the 21st. Oh, wait, no. The last active trade was on the 17th. So that was a Friday. So 1 week, 2 weeks. This is 3 weeks. This is going on 3 weeks. That can't be right. No, the EU one I took on the challenge. If that's the one you're talking about. Why can't I see the pair? That was on a gold. EU. It's been a little bit, I can tell you that. I haven't taken anything the end of September. Like the last thing I got involved in was like the EU before it took August low. Yeah, the trade you're talking about, that was a little ways ago too. That was for the F, that EU one, I'm talking about the big account. That account I was showing you, that was on September 23rd. So even that was, I didn't take that on the big account. But even that was, no, that can't be September 23rd. Oh, I'm looking at October. It was the 23rd. It was a Thursday. So that was like 2 weeks ago, maybe plus. But even still, right? Like, I mean, it's just about being patient. That was it. That was like the real last legit entry for EU before it made its continuation. All right. But yeah, there hasn't been many trades taken on the big one. All right, well, we're going to wrap it up there. I don't see any other questions, and I will post the link for tomorrow, and I will see you all for the NFP live trading. Hope you guys all have a great day, and I will see you all in the morning. Am I lagged? Can you guys hear me, see me? Is it good? Okay. Nobody was saying anything. So I flicked the VPN on, so I wasn't sure if it froze me up. Okay. All right. See you guys all in the morning.